Hi class, it's your instructor, Stephanie Yurisitz. These are your 1.1 video notes, and I'm just going to explain how the notes work again, just since this is your first set of notes you're taking in here. Typically, I will ask you to use your textbook to define some terms before you start watching the video. Multiple reasons for this. The main one is... Your textbook does a great job at explaining things. Three faculty members at PCC actually wrote it. So it's approachable. It's not like a standard math textbook where you open it up and you cringe, I promise. There are a lot of words on the page, but it's written so it makes sense. and I want to get you in the habit of using your textbook because they have a lot more examples than what we do together. And so if you're struggling, I really want you to see, you know, multiple sets of examples so it can click. So please do these definitions before you start the videos because we'll be using the terms throughout the videos. And then the videos will be broken up into short little segments. So in case, you know, you really get something, you don't have to rewatch that entire piece. You just like go to the little section that you need. So then the other thing is, you can print these notes, you can handwrite them, you can write on your own tablet, whatever works for you. But these notes will be due when you come into the midterm. They're graded on accuracy and completion. And so just make sure that you're taking notes, these video notes, however it fits your schedule, like, because I know some of us don't have printers or whatnot. All right, so the first two examples we're going to do in this video, we're going to talk about just if something's a proposition or not. And because you did your work and you looked up these terms before you started this video, you know a proposition is a statement that's either true or false. All right. So for example 1A, it says I went to the store. Well, it's a statement, so it makes that a complete sentence is another way to say that. And I know it's true or false. Either you do it or you don't. So this is a proposition. Example 1B, are you going out tonight? Well, that's a question. So I already know it's not a proposition. And also, I have no idea what you're going to tell me, yes or no. So I don't have a complete understanding of the truth value. So this is a no. Example 2, and you found this definition in your textbook, negation. It says negate the following propositions. In other words, we're going to say the opposite. Example 2A says, I want to watch a movie. If I want to negate that, I would write, I do not want to watch a movie. And the second one says, I do not like math. Hopefully that's not true. And if it is, I hope this class changes your mind. To negate that, I would say, I do like math. See what I got you to do there? All right, so I'm going to stop it here, and then we'll pick up on logical connectors.